Sound bad, dude. No, no, it's all for the good. It's for the good of the cause.
Good evening. It's 6 o'clock. My name is Vince Noblet, President of the Speedway Redevelopment Commission. Today is November 21st, and this is our regular scheduled session of the Redevelopment Commission. First, I want to start off with a roll call. Bill Jones.
Here.
Tom Popchef.
Here.
Ron Fisher.
Here.
And I am here. Allison Duncan couldn't attend tonight. Also in attendance is Dr. Terry Reed. Thank you for coming. Tim Jensen with Veritas Group is here. And we have a special guest, Linda Walters. Appreciate you being here, buddy.
Thank you.
Oh, you got made it up to the big chair. Okay, now we establish a quorum. I'm going to first on the agenda is approval of October 24th. 2016 regular session minutes. These minutes have been presented to the commission. They'll be approved unless I hear of any corrections or changes. As noted, hearing none, those minutes are approved. Next is the approval of the October 31st executive session minutes. These minutes have been presented to the commission. They will be accepted and approved as submitted. If I hear no changes to those minutes, hearing none, they're approved. Next is the approval of the October 31st, 2016 special session minutes. These minutes have been presented to the commission. They'll be approved if there's no changes or corrections. Hearing none, we'll move on. I know that we got a large crowd tonight. And I want everybody to have a chance to speak. If you'd come up and just state your name, and if you're a business owner or a property owner on Main Street, please let the commission know. If you're just anybody in town of Speedway, please just state that in your address. And I'm going to have Tim Jensen take notes on everything that you say, so feel free to present to the commission, and we'll look forward to listening and to understanding what your concerns are.
Tom's taking
notes. You're going to take notes on this? Both of you again. So at this point in time, I want to ask for public comment. If you would mind coming to the podium and speak, you'd be more than happy to.
Just want to say good evening.
Hi.
Julia Pratt. I live at 5106 West 10th Street. And I think I have two questions tonight. I see a sign for a public hearing at the corner of Ford Street and Main Street. And I'm just curious what the plans are for that corner. I wouldn't be in favor of tearing that building down for surface parking, and I just wondered what the plans were for that corner. And I think that's my only question.
I think that was not requested by the Redevelopment Commission. That was a property owner that requested that, and we're not gonna be hearing that tonight, especially.
Okay.
From that end, but I think it's for additional parking.
Okay.
Is what they're looking for.
Okay. Just wanted to pose that question tonight. Thank you.
Anybody else?
I have over.
You know what? There.
Here's the resolutions.
Hi, I'm Marcia Huff. We own a barbecue and bourbon. My husband's with me and my daughter, and we also own the building at 1414 Main Street. Our concern is the lack of parking that's going to be available once the new project goes in. That being said, we are 100% for the new project. We think that's fantastic, but we got to come up with a solution for parking so that we can continue to stay in business as our neighbors can also. And I think that's everyone's concern. Everyone wants to see this progress. I mean, we think it's awesome.
Right.
It's just, what are the plans? It went from 500, then I heard 150, and now I'm hearing 49.
Right. So. I will have Tim make a report to everybody concerning the parking at that point in time, so that it will definitely be part of tonight's discussion. And Tim, you can Why don't you just give everybody, not a review on that, but just to let her know about the parking committee that we are forming to get a
Sure. Thank you, Mr. President. So to address some of the known parking concerns that we already know about, we the commission has requested that our firm lead an effort to engage a parking committee to examine all the parking needs, the current needs, the future needs of not only the existing businesses, but what also the new businesses that would be part of the Wilshaw project and also Rosner coming into the Main Street area, what all of those needs will be and where the potential is to park the cars that are necessary. And so the commission has authorized the formation of a parking committee, which will consist of two council members, two commission members, one representative from the Wilshaw development team, as well as, it's up to the commission, two or three business owners on the north side, north end of Main Street, and they've already given us a few names of who that would be, to engage in a committee to look at, again, at all the needs and how we're going to solve the issues. So I'm a consultant for the Redevelopment Commission, and I think what I need you guys to hear tonight is that, and the commission, is that the commission sees this as a serious issue as well, but also it's one that is it's a good opportunity to have, right? Because 10 years ago, we weren't talking about parking problems on Main Street. So the fact that we're talking about parking problems along Main Street means there's people coming to Main Street, and there's things happening on Main Street, which all of you are part of. So I think the commission is interested and engaged in looking at this committee. From the timing perspective, we would expect the first meeting of the committee to happen the week after Thanksgiving. So sometime in the next 14 days, 10 to 14 days, that committee will be convened for the first time to talk about it. The way this process works with the Wilshaw organization or our development team is there's a lot of steps that the commission has already gone through, but there's still several steps to go through before it's an actual real project at the end of the day. One of the things we've told the Wilshaw team is that the parking issue must be solved prior to them purchasing the ground and the commission and the town committing ultimately to the project. And so while there has been an economic development agreement signed, there are 40 or 50 clauses from both the Redevelopment Commission and the Wilshaw development team that have to be satisfied in order for that to become a real deal. And part of that is obviously land closing. They can't close on the ground until several of these things are actually figured out, one of which is parking. And so it has to be to the satisfaction of the commission before it can be done, and that's why they formed the committee to start tackling that issue immediately. So
you might let the public know also, Tim, about how long we've been working on just the economic development agreement.
So there is a long process for public-private partnerships, which is what we have on the Wilshaw deal. And I think they were selected last October from a whole bevy of proposals that were due. I think we had six or seven responses in that. Yeah. And they were selected out of the six or seven responses as the best option for the town at the time. Since then, we've been working on an economic development agreement. So it took, it was just over 12 months to get to an economic development agreement with that company. And again, it's looking at a $38 million investment on Main Street, which will bring people, right? But people bring cars, and that's one of the issues that obviously we're talking about. So so at least 12 months.
Right.
With still
right.
several months to go to finish it.
In the economic development agreement, basically we called out, we might speak to a little bit of the development itself, you know, consisting of a hotel and two residential units. And you want to give them an update on that?
Sure. So the development as contemplated today as part of the economic development agreement includes a roughly 130-room hotel, which will be on the hard corner of Crawfordsville Road and Main Street up there on the roundabout, and then two individual residential buildings that come down south on Main Street, consisting of 90 units total. The parking that's provided with the project has changed over time due to some restraints, and we've had some meetings on utilities and other things that are on the site. And so, again, this is what's prompted the need, because the original parking garage that was suggested in the RFP was suggested without any knowledge of the actual site conditions, which don't permit for a 300-space garage or a 500-space garage. There's just simply no room for that on the site. And so what the commission had to decide at some point was, do we just want a huge parking garage on the site, which doesn't generate any revenue for anybody, or do we want, or doesn't bring residents, or do we want some residents and parking, and then look at the other options of parking around the area? So we have current ideas and plans. The commission does. We've looked at several options to increase parking within 3 months by up to 350 spaces on the north side of Main Street, so on the north end of Main Street. And we're looking at some parking agreements with some other local operators that have lots that aren't currently being utilized today. So,
right. I think the main point is that we are by far not finished with the parking arrangements and the complete deal. This has been a long process in which the commission has been holding a lot of meetings even to get to this point in time. I mean, we're talking 120, you know, each one of those hotel units have to have a dedicated key parking spot, you know, so that we have to make room for them. We're talking about all the residents on a four-story. We don't know if it's all going to be condos. It all depends on the, you know, if it's sold individually as condos or apartments. We, you know, we just don't know at this point in time. And that's one of the reasons that we, you know, want this parking committee to be formed, to keep the businesses informed. And, you know, my envision of, as the parking committee is formed and minutes are taken at each meeting, those minutes be basically put out to anybody that would like to see them, so that everybody can be informed at the same time. You know, we want to keep them. Also, we have to keep it in a pace in which we can. I don't want to slow the development standpoint either, because as far as the timeline right now, the EDA calls for a long period of time. We are going to hold them to a year and a half is what we're looking at, basically of getting that both buildings constructed at the same time. Or, you know, if we did them one at each other, it would take twice as long to get it done, so that we can be, you know, go ahead and take up the hotel and the individual units together. And Loftus Robinson is used to building quickly and efficiently. They're two loan units. We went up and saw their unit in Fishers, and their ones downtown. You know, these are really nice units. Bill had an opportunity to see it the other night.
Yeah, they're spectacular. I mean, there's what they build. Will bring a new level of sophistication to Main Street. They're very high end. Everybody will rave at the finished product of what they'll build.
Does anybody else want to speak to the commission? Please step up. You can.
Marie Hall, I have a business on Main Street. I think it's great you're going to do this, mm-hmm. but from the very, very beginning, at all times, we were going to have parking space. We were going to have parking space while you built the garage. We were going to have the garage parking space while you put the buildings in. We have to have parking. You don't want to destroy what you've already got on Main Street, and it's not me, but it's your restaurants and everything else. And where Rosner's is, you're going to have retail space there. You're going to put retail space in where the apartments and the hotel's at. That's going to take more parking spot. And then you talk about the high-end apartments. What apartment comes with one car? There's always two cars because it's a couple that can afford to live there. So we have to have parking. And this idea that IMS is giving us parking spot across Crawfordsville Road and we're going to walk down, all I've got to say is I don't mind walking, but I'm not walking that far. And all of the help that is paid minimum wage is not going to even bother walking. They're going to pull in the first spot. We have to have the parking. We want the building. I think it'll be great. You've done a fantastic job so far. Don't destroy what you've got there while you're building, because these little guys can't hold on. Dawson's, I've been keeping count of how many cars are in Dawson's parking lot during the day. They run between 25 and 45, depending upon what's going on there. And that's for Dawson's and rolling in the dough and maybe somebody walking on Main Street. So that's just what I see right there. And Marcia has the same thing. She's invested in her building. She wants to be catering and things. We've got to have it.
Right.
And what I've been promised from the very beginning is you'll have 100 spaces. Don't worry. We're going to do the garage. Don't worry. And then when it came down to October 31st and that meeting, I was told it's a done deal. We'll just have to find you some parking spot. I need to know, and your idea of having transparency from this new committee is fantastic. The whole town will love to see the transparency.
Right.
So please do what you're saying. Give us our parking. Give it us somewhere and say, you're going to park here for 3 months until we get back down here. Just tell us what you're doing.
Sure.
And continue doing it. But I don't want a shovel in the ground building a hotel till I've got parking.
Okay.
Okay.
What was your address, ma'am?
On 1434 Main Street.
Good evening. My name is Chris Jones. I'm at 4926 West 15th Street, which makes me one of the closest homeowners to this development. I'm two doors down from Tom. And I like your idea about the parking committee, but you did not mention you'd have any homeowners on there. We have concerns, too, with what's going to happen. I'm four houses down from Main Street. We understand we're going to lose the lot, what was referred to as Dawson's lot. I counted that. It's about 55 spaces. I understand the EDA says the parking garage is going to have 50 public spaces, but I also understand that says 35 of those spots are already being given to the Rosner development. So we're really only talking about 15. If it's as is, there's only going to be 15 spots available, and they can charge guests for parking at that, according to the EDA. So, you know, let's get this transparency going and tell, you know, tell us all the facts that are in that EDA about the parking so we know. And then the other question I have that would be important for that committee to address is, and similar to what Ms. Hall mentioned, is where will these employees park? You're going to have employees of the hotel, the shops, the apartments. Will they be parking in that garage, or were they going to be fighting with neighbors parking out in front of our houses looking for spots in the street?
Sure, that's the last thing we want to do is have, to have a lot of parking problems all up and down 15. We do have a lot of problems right now. I mean, there's a lot of people that like to park in front of houses and stuff, even across the lot. The lot might be totally empty, but they'll park in front of your house.
Correct.
No, they'll park in my house.
Yeah, your house first. Yeah. 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 My house. Close my house third.
I think Bob Moore's running something off that. You know,
he might be.
So I just ask that you consider.
No, I wanted to address a couple things that you're concerned. You know, Wilcox is an engineering consulting firm. You know, we use them here in town. Mm-hmm. And their employees, all their employees do not basically go to their office. They're currently up in Park 100 now. Mm-hmm. And so they'll, at the most, have between 10 and 15 parking spots in their current building used. They're not going to be parking their trucks and all that at the lot. And they're going to be working 8 to 5.
But doesn't the agreement say 35 spots?
It does. We had to reserve 35, okay, you know, from that end of it. And it's also, there'll be some flux in relationship to the parking spots for residents. You know, that's if it's completely sold out, you know, right off the bat. I hope so at that point in time. And then also the room level rate. Mm-hmm. But we have to have enough spots for worst case scenario. And just like Marie said, that, you know, what if you have, you know, we don't know what's going to go in the retail end of it. Mm-hmm. So, you know, that's a question. So we have to build that into, you know, pro forma that we can make it. But getting this development and off the ground, $37 million investment, and also getting high-end consumers into Main Street, you know, that will use it. We've got to solve this issue. We understand that.
Okay.
And this commission is going to be take arrangements to make sure that we get that done and keep everybody informed. And this is not going to be a one-time deal. You guys are more than welcome to come any of our meetings at this point in time, anytime.
Okay.
From that. Or you can, you know, email your concerns to anybody that's on this commission.
Okay.
Be glad to help you out. Tim, tell them about the proposed agreement with the IMS. You know, this is, they're allowing us to develop the Wilshaw development, to develop 200 parking spaces across Crawfordsville Road. So, you know, the first question is, do I have to invest in a pair of track shoes to get across Crawfordsville Road? No, we have engaged American Structure Point to take a look and see what kind of safety procedures that we can put into play to get people, to slow people down. The speed limit on that roundabout is 15 miles an hour. It probably, I would say they're averaging 40, you know, and we're not in the position of enforcement. That's our police department does that. So we have to bring it to their attention that, guys, you got to help us out a little bit. And we also have to, there's things that can be done. Number one, just what we did on Main Street. You know, the traffic on Main Street was, and probably still is, going faster than what they should be. But at least we have crosswalks that are visibly marked. And then we also reinstate the positive of being, okay, if somebody's in that crosswalk, you got to stop. You got to allow the public to cross. You can't just plow right through there. And, you know, it does concern me. And so I want us to have Structure Point is researching that, and they're going to be presenting to the commission what can we do to help mitigate that problem and at least maybe not resolve it, but at least mitigate it.
Did you want me to?
Yeah, I was going to explain on the what's going to take place in the parking lot and then who's going to be parking there.
Well, I think it's important to know first that the commission already has a parking agreement with the IMS for the what is currently a gravel area on the north side of Crawfordsville Road. And conversation aside about how far away it is, we've been asking them to fully develop that and get that paved and improved over time. Part of what's
coming. Let me state that that parking agreement was when we sold
right.
the property to the Speedway.
Oh, a year and a half ago. Or
yeah,
so.
So that the town could use that as an overflow area. This isn't something that we just came up with.
Yeah, so the intent then is to actually engage them in making them complete that. And the developer of the Wilshaw project has stepped up and said they will assist in the cost of that parking lot in order to maintain the parking that's required. Even the Wilshaw guys see this as an overflow lot, and they intend to valet on the other side of that lot, and they intend to make all of their hotel employees and restaurant employees park on the other side. We've asked them about how you know, how do you audit that? How do you enforce that? How do you do that? And they are coming up with parking passes for their lots and parking passes for the other lots, so they know which employees are where. And they've it's part of their it's going to be part of their parking agreement, which is contemplated in the EDA about how that's enforced to make sure that they're parking their 30 to 40 employees on the north side of Crawfordsville Road. And as Vince indicated, part of this whole thing is how do we get foot traffic safely across Crawfordsville Road on the roundabout? Because if that's going to be used for anybody, whether it's overflow or direct parking or whatever you want to call it, it needs to be a safe passage for people. So it's all being considered and will be considered heavily over the course of the next 2 to 3 months before we get to a property closing sometime first quarter of next year is the anticipated date.
Okay. Anybody, let me open it back up. Hey, Chuck.
Good evening, how are you?
Okay.
Charles Bennett, 4934 West 15th Street, as a resident here. And also as a resident who's been before this commission, I counted no less than 11 times. Most recently, back in May 2016, July 2016, February 2016, making questions about the Wilshaw project, requested the Wilshaw RFP from the town in which I got that, and in that they stated that they had had public meetings for input on that particular project, which I must have missed or did not see any of those meetings, because I surely would have attended, as I've been on several planning commissions and input commissions and charrettes. To say that we didn't know there was going to be a parking problem, I think, is an inaccuracy. I'll cite page 21 of the master plan from this particular speed zone. Main Street currently has approximately 285 parallel and angled parking spaces. Under the current streetscaping plan, the on-street parking will be increased to approximately 320 spaces. A parking garage with street level retail is proposed at Main Street and 14th Street that will potentially contain another 450 spaces, so right smack dab in the middle. An additional off-street parking is proposed to the east end of Main Street along Gilman. This parking lot could contain up to 400 additional parking spaces. We also, I believe, paid for a study from the ULI, the Urban Land Institute, in which they said the district must have a seamless connection with surrounding residential areas, a comfortable ambience, and plentiful adjacent parking that is ideally a combination of on-street spaces, parking behind buildings, and structured parkings. The ULI further went on to say that providing public parking is another important feature to be addressed as new. This is on page 26. Higher density development occurs along Main Street. Although the panel does not think a short-term need exists right now for the proposed parking garage, when it is necessary, funding could be driven from special revenue bonds paid for by parking fees. Alternatively, the town could create a Main Street parking district that develops, regulates, and funds all on and off-street parking, which I don't think we totally funded, but in 2009, we had another study paid for by the commission in which we laid out the amount of spaces that we had, what the plan was going to be, how we could accommodate all of the great business that's going in on Main Street as well. So for me personally, to say that there's a parking issue and it has not been known is not correct, because I've been before this commission several times and suggested. I went before the zoning board as well, suggested I could give them several studies before they voted on the Big Woods project to tear down a historic home and put a parking lot there. No one wanted to postpone that for a week so we could provide all that. But I have tons of information on that, and we'd be happy to provide it in the, as I have in the past. My other concern is, as a resident, is for the hotel going in. I understand that everyone thinks that's going to be a great thing, but as someone who lives six houses down, it's not my idea of the development. It's not my idea of what was laid out in the speed zone SZ1 redevelopment and classification to get its own zoning place. To my knowledge, it did not recommend that there be any hotels in there. Mixed village use, yes, certainly. Two- and three-story buildings, certainly. None of that that's going to, in my opinion, not go along with the development of SZ1. Furthermore, I know I've cited these studies several times, but the Urban Land Institute said that there should be an IMS expansion museum entertainment retail, but that should come north of 16th Street. I think if the IMS is wanting to partner with us, great, let's put a hotel, let's put a convention center, let's put something there, a new museum. I think that's great. You keep that development on that side, and then you have parking that you can still develop in the area where it is. And then I know that Loftus Robinson used Pro Horvath as their economic analysis. You guys did too in 2009, in which they laid out four specific developments for the Main Street, which had a north, south, east, and west. And they said, again, to the north of 16th Street, a new hotel with an integrated conference center, a new theme restaurant, relocation, expansion of the IMS Hall of Fame Museum, and offices related to the IMS Hall of Fame Museum could be put there. As my residents, again, I'm happy for all the businesses that are down there. I want them to survive. I don't think they will with the hotel, apartments. I don't think we're following anything that we paid lots of money to have studies for. I'm just concerned. So to say that, though, that these issues haven't been brought up before, that's not correct either, because I've been here several times with the same thing. So
thank you.
Thank you.
What is the average cost of a parking space in a high rise?
In a garage?
Parking garage.
$18,000.
$18,000. So we're looking at, for, you know, a couple hundred spaces, a lot of money. And, you know, that's what this commission has to look at, too. The last thing we want to do is raise residence taxes, business taxes in relationship to. Nobody wants to pay more money. Nobody even wants to pay for parking, you know, from that end of it. We don't have meters. We don't, you know, and, you know, so we got to look at what is the most efficient way that we can get customers and employees and businesses along Main Street and without charging for it. And I mean that because, you know, the mantra of, you know, build it and they will come, you know, type of thing. Well, until they come, who's going to be paying for it? We don't want to get in that position. And I think we have ground that is available on Main Street still, that 1400 block that Chuck was alluding to, that we can build a parking garage on. But you have to have enough volume to justify it, you know, from that standpoint. Now, to say you got the Wilshaw project, well, they should pay for a garage for the rest of the town. Well, the problem is when we looked at it, you know, it wouldn't pay for itself. And then that's where the value, the AV that's generated off of that structure, you know, wouldn't pay for the amount of bonds that would be have to be taken out. You know, from that standpoint, this project works. It pays for itself. And that's where we're moving forward at this point in time. But we need to do it smart. We have to understand where we're going to get, where are all these people going to park in the meantime until we get the structure built at that point in time with the the number of individuals that are down there right now, the Wilcox development. We got, you know, a $3 million building going up right now that will be open up January 15th at the Rosner building. And those employees are going to need a place to park too, you know, from that end of it. So, and that's where we got, that's where this, we've got to come together as a town and understand what we want to do and where we're going to put all those cars from that standpoint. Yeah, would anybody else like to speak to the commission tonight? Go right ahead.
I'm Shirley Nelson, and I'm a business owner on Main Street, the yes. Press, newspapers. We're also Speedway residents at 2012 North Auburn. And we are concerned because I don't think you guys have been transparent. And you said email if you have any questions. I emailed every one of you. And I got no response from anybody. I just want to point that out.
Right.
And also, you're building a hotel and apartments and condos, and what you're proposing doesn't even cover those for parking. 269 spots was my understanding, is what will end up being built. A 269 spot parking garage, correct? Am mm-hmm. I wrong?
It's in that range. Yeah, it's 265, it's 270, depending on the final. But yeah,
that hardly covers what you got. I mean, 130 room hotel, and then you consider two parking spaces per condo, an apartment. I mean, that's all I want to say.
Right.
But please be transparent.
You know, there's a fine line when you're negotiating, talking to business owners of how much you can say at this time. And the commission is always challenged with that.
Sure.
That, you know, just like any of the business and property owners in this room tonight, that you would not want me to get up and speak about the deal that we're working on in relationship to that.
Okay.
Publicly.
I understand that.
Until we are able to speak about it, I would love to do that, and give as much detail as what we've got at this point in time. But for me to just to come out and say something and violate the trust of a person that is putting a lot of money
into it. I understand what you're saying, and I can agree with that.
Okay.
I really do.
Right.
But you're saying, from here on out with this committee, the parking committee,
yes.
There's going to be transparency.
That's why we're putting two council members on,
mm-hmm.
along with two commission members, business owners, and some residents.
And then
we can take minutes and send it out to whoever wants to get it, you know,
thank
at that
you.
Point in time.
Hello.
How you doing?
Good. My name is Brad Bainbridge, and I'm not a property owner of a business, but I do own a house at 5623 West 29th Place. And I just wanted to stand up on behalf of the businesses because I experienced a very similar situation in California where a development came in, we met with the town, and all kinds of promises were made. And at the end of the day, when the parking went away, 30 to 40% of everybody's business went away. We lost 135 spots. And we were told that the lots would be cordoned off. Well, the construction was one end, it would be on one end, and then on the other end, it would be graveled, and you know, we'd be have access to parking. At the end of the day, it didn't happen. I understand it's a different place. But I think people need to be prepared that if there is no parking, convenient parking is really the key word. If there's no convenient parking, people will not come down. And we have a disproportionately large elderly crowd. Right. Like I saw Ed Frazier today at Dawson's. You won't see that. If there's not, you won't see that if they have to walk from Crawfordsville Road. And I just know from my personal experience, I lost a lot of money. I sold my business for like $17,000. Trust me, I had a lot more than that in it. So it's really can be devastating. This wasn't a hotel. This was an office building. But it can be really devastating to lose your convenient parking. Yeah. And that's all I wanted to say.
I think, you know, that's right now the commission has a large number of spots. Wendell, you know the count on that on Gilman and Allison Way. We're adding spots on the north side of the street. Give everybody an update.
We're, we're looking at 38 to 42 spots. We had to make a change because of some utilities, but that project should be completed by end of week. Those spaces should become available next Monday. There's a delay on the light poles. Those will be installed in February, but the parking spaces should come available to us after the Thanksgiving holiday week.
And I realize that's on the other end of it, but we addressed what we're doing is addressing it now for the south end of Main Street to add more parking spaces to the area. In addition to the lighting, and who said, you know, okay, who's going to want to walk from Allison Way over? Employees will. And that's where we're going to need the help of businesses. If, you know, if you have employees and say, just, you know, I don't care if it's a light day or a busy day, you guys, these are parking lots designated for employee parking only. So, and you guys got to be basically monitoring that. Because I'm not going to know who your employees are, you know, from that standpoint, unless we identify their cars, you know, give them a hang tag or whatever that they have to put in the windshield. But that's for the parking committee and for those guys to decide the specifics in relationship. But we just, if you pull those employees out of that area, that's going to make even that much more room for the very convenient parking spaces right up front from that end of it. I think there's still a large area within Area 1 that it's not developed. You know, there's several buildings that have large parking lots that there's nobody in. And it's, you know, the commission is going to go around and ask those owners if we can utilize some of that spaces, at least for this year and a half, to help us through that transition period. You know, if we got to pay for them or we got to clean their lot, we'll do it. But those are things that we're planning on being proactive and doing it for that at this point in time. And, you know, Big Woods right now, they are taking it on themselves to even add more spots for their specific location. Is there anybody else that would like to address the commission tonight? Chris?
Hi there. My name's Chris Hill. I own Dawson's on Main with my brother, 1464 Main Street. And I guess I see myself as kind of the guinea pig because I have been here for 10 years. I just want to be assured to the best of your guys' abilities that the end game, when we're done, because I've been through the redevelopment, you know, I went through the four stages and it hurt like crazy. It really did. But the town supported me a great deal, supported us, and I firmly believe that they will support Main Street businesses. I don't know that we'll all survive, because a year and a half is a real kick instead of, you know, I think we in stage three or four, whatever stage we were, was 4 months. This is 2 months of the Indy 500, which a lot of us pay our bills, a lot of bills through those 2 months, and you know, that parking lot is completely full for basically a month. And for that to be gone, I know there's some residents that get mad at Dawson's people because we do park in front of their places, and they tell us about it, and it stinks. And I know I will be able to enforce with my employees said parking lot. Whatever we tell them, they'll do it. And I know that will happen, and I will do it, and everybody that is involved with Dawson's will do it, and we're prepared to do it because we've done it in the past. But my biggest concern is at the end game, when everything is done, because I know there's a problem down on the south end. You just have to get on social media to figure it out, that those residents down there are up in arms because maybe a lack of planning or maybe whatever. Well, I don't want to have that situation when we have a new restaurant, we have a new hotel, we have new condos, we have new everything. It's beautiful on Main Street, and I'm proud to say that I'm a part of it. But the end game that we will have proper parking. So we're all not just, I'll go back. When we did the redevelopment, I was kind of the only show, Charlie Brown's and I was the only show in town. There weren't other alternatives. My biggest concern when this construction is going on, lack of parking, I mean, the Fraziers came in to eat today, and they're the type of people that will drink water and split a tenderloin. That's who keeps my doors open. Those are the people that pay my bills. And I have about 40 employees that I have to look after, and I'm passionate about it.
I totally agree with you, Chris. I mean, I think that's one of the reasons that we wanted you involved with the parking committee, to have direct input, to make sure that decisions are made correctly, and that as we move forward to really lessen the impact that it does. One good thing this time around, we're not digging the streets up.
Yeah, I appreciate that.
You won't have a 20-foot hole outside of your building to cross over at that point in time. And but, you know, when we purchased that lot, the Praxair lot, you know, Praxair didn't want to sell that lot. They did not want to sell it. And we told them how important it is that we add those parking spaces to make Main Street successful from that end of it. But there was always the vision, and Chuck, you know, mentioned several reports, but as you looked at the drawings and sketches that were laid out for that area, it was a high-rise, you know, a facility, a multi-use facility. And I think all of us could envision that, because, you know, those people are millennials. They don't know how to cook, you know. They just go in there and sleep and come out, and then they got to figure out a place to eat, you know, from that end of it. And the same with the hotel. We wanted it hadn't been announced yet, and I've got to let, you know, the developer announce the hotel from that standpoint. But it's a top name hotel that is going in there, and so that you got 120 units that will need some. Restaurant. It'll have a slight restaurant within in the bottom, but they'll get, you know, they'll definitely be over to your place to eat from right. That standpoint.
I can appreciate all that. You made a comment earlier about higher end clientele. Well, I kind of like my clientele that I have now. And I heard a couple murmurs out there.
No, so I know.
I might want to watch how you say that one. But, I guess, and Lee, and I'll end with this. I'm just concerned about Motel 6. The end game is what I'm concerned about the most. I mean, I'm worried about the process. And, you know, hopefully Dawson's is here for another 30 years. But if we don't provide the adequate parking and people can't get to us or they have to work to get to us, I think we'll all just die a slow death. I really, truly believe that. I've done this enough to, you know, I've seen a lot of curveballs in 10 years. But I want to make sure that during the process, obviously, is huge. But the end game, when we all survive and you know, that we have the adequate parking and we're not reactive, we're a little bit proactive. And I don't want to have the issues that we have down South End of the street. So,
Chris, so Vince did do all the talking. I want you to know this.
Thanks.
I'm talking about individually, the commission, me as a person. We have executive meetings. We have special sessions. They're not open to the public. But we open our mouths and we listen to you. And we're concerned about it. Now, this is going to be one of my last meetings because I'm leaving the commission. But I agree with you guys. Parking is a serious problem. But it takes time to get bonds issued. There's a lot of things yet to go through for this. So this isn't starting construction tomorrow. And I can guarantee you this commission, the town council, is all aware of the parking. And I do appreciate all of you coming out tonight.
Thanks, guys.
Okay. Did you want to speak?
I'm Ann Mitchell. I live at 4908 Baxter Drive, which is at the north end of Main Street,
okay.
Well above Robbinsville Road. In large part, we bought our property in 2007 because of the redevelopment plan. It's beautiful, absolutely gorgeous. We're very happy to have been a part of this growth. I also want to remind people that several of us in town have a little bit of PTSD from the 2013 parking debacle, when the town decided that we were going to do this parking permit thing and that people could no longer put things out to hold our parking during the month of May or during race events for ourselves and our friends. And that was not transparent, not at all. And part of why we bought here was because we thought it was very quaint that the people who live here, the town, the merchants, and IMS cooperatively work together to make the race happen. We thought that was really cool. And then we have this parking thing where we're going to have parking permits and people can't park here and they can't do this and they can't do that and you can't put the cones out and you can't put chairs out in the street. That we thought that was quaint. We've been coming here. I've only been coming since 95, but my husband's been coming since 1964. We thought it was cute. It happens a few weekends a year. It's not like an everyday thing. It was nice. It was really nice that we got to do that. That thing happened in 2013, and that all went away, and that didn't work, by the way. But now that's changed. So this thing about transparency for a bunch of us is very real. That was not a transparent process. It happened against the wishes of lots of people who live here. And so now we're faced with another big parking issue. And we just want to make sure that people, not only we know everyone has taken it seriously, but that people who live here get to know what's going on. And that we get to be part of making those decisions and figuring out how to do this. And then the last thing I want to say is we rarely go to Broad Ripple or Fountain Square. There's really cool places there, but you can't find parking. Parking is really hard. So let's try and build that in so that people can still come here and enjoy everything, and we have adequate parking, and the process is done openly so that we know what's going on. So thank you.
My name is Chuck Schumann. I live at 4908 Baxter Drive. My wife, Ann. I won't reiterate because everybody's covered it really well.
Right.
First of all, what you've done with redevelopment is fabulous. We're 100,000% behind it. It's always been great. And the visibility and the transparency is important. But I don't think we should get too married to a plan that is going to leave us with a permanent problem that can cause this slow death that was described. And the fact that you got a big hotel company interested in coming here is because we've really got the jewel. I mean, that corner is one of those unique corners in the United States. And there can be some money brought to bear on that. So we don't have to listen to the guy say, well, my pockets are almost empty. They're building a plan, and it's compressing upon itself to sustain the selfish interests of that particular set of owners and businesses. And that's okay. They have to do that. But they have to live in this town. And this town's got a jewel at the corner. And we need to go back to the well, bring in some other partners, and do the plan right through this community involvement that you're going to do. I don't think we should get too married to the first plan or even the fifth plan. It's got to be the right plan, because if you don't get it right, it's the slow death. And I want to mention two communities. Carmel. I work up in Carmel now, and there's a couple of areas up there that were developed. They're beautiful. You can't park there. Go there at lunchtime, forget about it. You got to wait just to find a spot to park. Go down to Florida, some of those towns down in Florida where they did the development, and you can tell they built the parking in because you can always find a place to park. And it's integrated into the architecture, it's integrated into the community. It doesn't look like a monstrosity that's awful ugly. So we should take the time to get the plan right. And if the current plan is the wrong plan, we should face that. And I'm not saying it is, but we should challenge our partners that want to come up here and spend money to make money to suck it up and make a good plan that's going to withstand time. And that was my comment.
Thank you, Joe. Anybody else would like to speak to the commission on it? George.
Hey. George McManus with Rolling in the Dough, 1502 Main Street. My wife and I own that. And certainly, we had the same concerns being a small cafe. And certainly, Chris, I think addressed the end game is very, very important. I'd like you guys to kind of talk a little bit about the construction side, because it hurt us a lot during the roundabout, closure and the street closure for that. So if you could talk a little bit about the construction, or at least as what you know, and if the staging of the development is going to be, maybe something, is it going to come off of Main Street? Is it going to come off of the 16th Street, or is there someplace else in conjunction with Proxair that it could be to alleviate, that
a lot of workers on the
up and down Main Street. Piece of it. You guys have any kind of information on that?
Well, I know there's going to be an entrance. The main entrance to the hotel is going to be off of 16th Street, and right there, just it would be west of the Speedway gas station. And so I take it that, that area is not going to be built on because there's a main sewer that goes through there. And so that will probably be a primary entrance for them to start the construction. The builders right now are planning on to start on all three projects at the same time to expedite the building of it so that we can minimize the amount of construction traffic. Now, the Rosner building, they had an alley to work with, and that was it, from that end. So a lot of it was shoved over across the street, and thankfully we have a place for them to stage their building constructions. So they're going to be, I'm sure, staging a lot of their construction right where the parking is on the inside of the perimeter. But I don't know enough specifics about, how their construction, we hadn't learned that from that end of it at this point in time. But we can definitely take those concerns and get back to everybody on, okay, here's the construction schedule and entrances. Window, when we have any closures, there's a water main coming off of Main Street, 5-inch line or 6-inch line. That goes to Praxair, we have to move that. So that's going to entail that it will probably come in off of 16th Street, but we need to talk to Praxair about that. The same way with sewer connections for the buildings and everything from that. So I would think that we would be able to connect to the sewer line that's right underneath the building.
Yes, hopefully so.
Yeah, fairly close to it. So that means that we won't be digging up Main Street, you know, and we'll keep that open from that end. But the building's going to be pushed all the way out to the front of the sidewalk. So they'll be working off of that. Around the roundabout is going to be off the roundabout a little bit to allow for pedestrian traffic because, you know, you got to think that race time and major events, you shove a lot of people down there. And so, you know, you got to leave. And then from a hotel standpoint, the people want to sit out and enjoy watching the cars, I guess, or just watching the on the roundabout from that end of it. But Wendell and the commission can help keep the business and the public informed of that construction schedule, you know, when it's going to start and what's going to happen as much as possible.
And it's intended to be a year and a half is what the...
That's the projected.
The projected.
Yeah, yeah. Given the weather and conditions from that standpoint.
And when is the anticipated start? Assuming that we, you know, everything, you close and in the first quarter.
It would be in April.
April or May. Obviously, we're trying to avoid May at all costs. But so you'd probably see a shovel in the ground if everything proceeds sometime in April with a big, long pause before a real construction start in June.
Okay. As far as the parking committee, how do you select people for that, or how does that process work?
I mean, you can volunteer, you know, just, you know, submit your name to the council or the commission.
Or Vince or Tom, right?
And then we can, you know, we got to keep a reasonable amount. I can't have 50 people on a parking committee. You know, I've got to be able to get our job done.
Yeah, we want a reasonable amount.
Yeah.
We also want to be able to hold those meetings at convenient times where everybody can participate. Okay. Because I've heard that continually from a lot of the stakeholders, a lot of the business owners on Main Street, and that is, I mean, you expect transparency, and that's what we hope to provide. But you can imagine attempting to coordinate logistics of getting 15 or 20 people together could almost be impossible. So, I mean, if you do have an interest, please, you know, share that with us. We have an idea. It's going to be up to the council and the commission to select those that really have a lot at stake of this and those that can bring a very open mind and some creative concepts as well. So if you have an interest, George, absolutely, we'll give that very strong consideration.
Yeah, I'd definitely like to be considered. My background, I've got 33 years of a commercial real estate experience with building stuff all over the country. So I certainly could help and bring bring some knowledge to the table to help everybody.
Good.
I think.
Well, I appreciate that offer.
So, okay.
Thank you.
Anybody else would like to speak to the commission? All right, we'll move on. Next on the agenda is Resolution 2016-4, Resolution of the Speedway Redevelopment Commission approving the payment of the surety facility premiums and reimbursement of the Redevelopment Commission.
I'll make a motion that the commission pass Resolution 2016-4, a resolution of Speedway Redevelopment Commission approving the payment the surety facility premiums and reimbursement of the Redevelopment Commission.
I got a motion. Is there a second?
I'll second.
I got a motion and a second. And now, is there any discussion? Tom, do you want to tell the public basically what this is?
Well, what this does is this, it's actually an insurance policy for the payments of the bonds. And if there are essentially any shortfall in bond payments, the surety company will cover that shortfall. That also frees up some additional funding to allow the commission to apply those funds to to other initiative projects within that particular TIF district.
Just to let everybody know, that's what is paying for the sewer line that is going in between Main Street and Poco. That heads our, it's our main sewer line that goes to, it's been there since 1920. You know, it was a brick line, and now we're replacing it because we can't afford it to collapse. And so through council's consideration, we made it a priority to get it done. It's also paying for the finishing of the B&O line on top, so that will be completed at least to Speedway's order there and get it up to 10th Street.
And while we're talking about parking, I think it also adds how many parking places?
42. Yeah, 38 to 42 spots.
Yeah, and that's what's paying for that, you know, from that end of it. Is there any other discussion? Hearing none, I'll call for a vote. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed? Motion carries 4-0. Okay, next on is Resolution 2016-5, Resolution Town of Speedway Redevelopment Commission. Preliminary determine and enter into a lease.
I'll make a motion we approve Resolution of the Town Speedway Redevelopment Commission preliminary determining the enter into a lease.
Okay.
I'll second that.
Got a motion and a second. Is there any other discussion?
Yeah, Mr. President. Yeah. I don't know that this resolution actually calls for an approval tonight. Per the attorney, Dennis Otten from Bose McKinney, this was an introductory resolution to be taken action upon in December. It is regarding the Wilshaw project.
So we just bring it to...
Yes, he just wanted to make sure it was... Point. Yeah, because there would be a public hearing on this in December. And, again, this is for notification only at this time. So... no action is actually, we don't want action on it tonight.
I'll withdraw my motion.
So we're just letting it out.
There are a couple other steps that have to take place as part of this overall process of the bonds and everything else. As we've already talked about tonight, there's multiple steps in this process.
Okay.
So.
Good.
Hey, Vince, you actually need to withdraw the motion in a second.
Yes.
Okay.
I'll withdraw the second.
Good. And withdraw the motion then. Thank you, Gary. Okay, next, we've been discussing the Wilshaw project all night, but I think we need to discuss, you know, basically we went over all the parking arrangements, the parking committee. We already went over the EDA previously. I had... Drew and Kyle Robinson was in at the commission, and everybody, I'm sure, saw him on TV basically explaining the development. If anybody wants to see any drawings or whether we can email them to you and let you take a look at it at this point in time, it is open for public viewing. We'll let you look at that. Is there anything else that we need to discuss tonight on that? Hearing none, I'll move on. Wendell, can you give us an update on sewer project and parking spaces?
Yes, sir. On our 72-inch sewer replacement upgrade there, we have, as of to date, 470 feet installed of a 1,000-foot run. We will start bypassing on the 29th of November. It's a 9 to 10-day job, weather permitting. We've sent out notice on lane restrictions and traffic control between 11th and Gilman when this bypassing project starts, and everything is always weather dependent. You'll see all my notes I put out there, everything's dependent on the weather, but we should meet schedule. Like Vince was saying, at the end of the project we will have our rails to trails, the extension of the B&O put back in place, the Gilman Allison Way parking will be completed and usable. The lighting, once I said once before, will be installed in February because we had a delay on manufacturing of the poles. But we will send out another notice on the lane restrictions, just as a reminder. We'll post it to Facebook, web, everything that we can get it out to. And if there's questions or concerns, please get a hold of us. We'll try and address them as quickly as possible. And just 9-10 days, hopefully we're out of the street and project's tightening up.
Great, thank you. Any other questions for Wendell? Hearing none, I'll move on. Tim, can you give us an update on the Crawfordsville Road development?
Yes, Mr. President. The Crawfordsville Road project that you're referring to is south of the high school road intersection there, where the new Burger King is now open. You'll also see a small strip center being constructed there at this time, which is projected to be turned over to the tenants sometime in January to be completed sometime maybe late February. I think there are six users in there, 4 to 6 users, depending on how big a space they need. We've been told that the gas station that was going to go on the corner has been delayed until first quarter of 2017 for a start.
Right.
And then there's also two other projects that are anticipating breaking ground even in December this year.
Right.
In the back part of that section.
So Get and Go has purchased the property.
Correct.
They've already purchased the ground. And they wanted to take a closer look because there's 5 other developments going around town in central Indiana, and they wanted to make sure that they had the way that they were going to position their pumps and the way the building, the size of the building and everything else, they wanted to get it right because they're spending quite a bit of money. I guess it's the same plan for all these locations. So that's why they dug the footers and then they filled them back in, and then they'll be digging them out again. You know, they are behind on this, on their commitment for a development in that site, and we're watching them very closely in relationship to that because they have guarantees that they have to meet as far as those bond payments, and it's important that they make their commitment, and we've made them aware of that now for over a year.
Mm-hmm.
With meetings with them. So we'll continue to monitor that and develop the progress. But they have some interesting developments going in that site, which will help them get the price that they want and develop it as needed. But is that all you have?
That's it.
Okay.
Question. What are the other two projects that's going in other than the gas station?
They haven't announced those yet, you know, publicly. So
Burger King, it's already open.
Yeah, the Burger King. And the gas station have already purchased, but they have LOIs with companies, and I can't divulge their name until they divulge the name. And then
it was in public record in the IBJ.
If it's in for which one?
For Starbucks.
Tell.
When the IBJ, it was Starbucks, said they took 2,200 square feet. So, I mean, that's public record.
That's inside the
strip center.
Yeah,
that's in the strip. That's not a individual dwelling.
That's right.
He mentioned two others. Gas
there are two parcels behind the gas stations, which they have either purchase and sale agreements in place for. But as Mr. Noblet already indicated, we're not at liberty to discuss what those are until the developer makes the announcement individually of who the end users are. I would expect that to come out here in the next 30 days.
Okay. Anything else?
Not on that one.
Tim, can you give an update on the Rosner development? Where are they at on that?
The only development update, Mr. President, is that they have pushed the move-in date to January 15th is what they're telling us now. They appear to be on schedule for that, but we'll continue to watch that as they move forward. But
that's the move-in for
Wilcox.
Wilcox Environmental.
Yeah.
Right.
And I know they're talking to a potential user for the first floor. But again, we don't know, haven't seen a lease or letter of intent or anything from them.
Okay. Any other questions? We'll move on. Approval of claims.
I'll make a motion that we approve the claims as submitted by the treasurer.
Okay. Got a motion? Do I have a second?
I'll second that.
Okay. Is there any discussion concerning the claims?
A little bit. There's a 1911 grill agreement. Who wrote our restaurant incentive agreement?
The original one was Bose McKinney.
Dennis Sutton?
It was, no, it wasn't Dennis. That was Alan Townsend, I think.
Alan Townsend. Well, I see they got 3.5 hours of work here. Most of it's conference calls with you, sir.
Mm-hmm.
And they haven't even got to the place to sign with Sarah Fisher yet.
This is for the redo of that agreement, Ron.
3.5 hours?
I mean, it was a completely redone. This is on the incentive that we looked at. That was what that is.
Very excessive. I can't vote in favor of that.
Okay.
Also, they have $10,534 total there. When did we vote on hiring them to go out and talk to various owners?
Hiring
a $410 attorney plus various group at $125. When did we vote on that?
We talked to in a special session. No, it wasn't a special session. It was an executive session about getting appraisals on the properties and talk to the owners. I'm almost sure that you were in that meeting, Ron.
I have not missed a meeting in 3 years, other than the one I had a stroke. I don't remember that, and that's $10,000, but to have $500 an hour going out and talking to people, I'm opposed to that.
And Tim was in that, in those discussions with Alan.
He's the lightweight in the group, but, I mean, there was no...
That meeting, that was discussed in an executive session, and we approved.
You were there?
Yes, sir.
We can't approve anything in the executive session.
No, the admonition to go out and seek input from those property owners and to do appraisals was in the executive session, which is part of real estate negotiations, which is covered in
the
special session.
I want to see the minutes
session.
Of those minutes meetings because I don't recall when they were, so I'd like to see the minutes. I oppose that section.
Okay.
$10,534.
I can put those on hold. Any other discussion?
No, it's not fair to hold up the sewer guy because he's. We got to get the sewer line in bed.
No, just those two. Mm-hmm. We can hold up those two. You know from that? Any other discussion?
That's it.
Got a motion. And so if I put those two items on hold.
Told us $10,534.
Right.
Which two?
It's the real estate and the real estate and the incentive agreement.
Okay.
Got a motion. Two people here tonight that received money from that already. So I
got a motion on the table, and so I'm going to call for a vote. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed? Motion carries 4-0. Anything else come before the commission tonight?
Should we discuss the purchase agreement?
Yeah, we can. Go ahead.
So the commission, through mutual negotiations, agreed to buy the property that we've referred to as the Beaudry property through a negotiated purchase. and that purchase agreement has been submitted by our council. And I think that we should vote to allow that purchase to go through. So I would move that we approve the purchase agreement that was submitted by our attorney for the purchase of the Beaudry property.
And just to make it clear, this Tom Beaudry, it's Bogner.
Bogner, I'm sorry. Mary Lou Bogner, also known as Mary Lou Beaudry.
And this is the screen printing place that is currently located at Georgetown Road, you know, from that end of it. And Tom would be moving, hopefully, to another location in Speedway, and so that we can keep the business here. From that end of it, but the total amount of it is
the total amount of the purchase is $760,000.
Okay.
You made a motion, Bill?
Yes.
I'll second it.
Okay, so we got a motion and a second. Is there any other discussion? Hearing no discussion, I call for a vote. All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Aye. All those opposed? Motion carries. Okay, it is 7:17. I call for adjournment.
Taking the overtime,
yep.
Aren't we?
Absolutely. I want to thank everybody for coming tonight. We usually don't get the kind of attendance, not even all year. So I appreciate you guys coming out.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for your input, and
the one that
we'll definitely
just
be back with.
Should have Allison on there, not okay. Me.